The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 15 through 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in November of 1966 in New York.
Jnana Jyotgena Cha Api Anne Jajantumam Upasate Ekatvena prithaktvena bahudha visyato mukham. Now, those who are directly worshipping the Supreme Lord, Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, they have been described as Mahatma. And there are other worshippers, they cannot conceive of the Supreme Personality of Godhead directly, on account of being less advanced. Therefore, they have been described here, anne, others. So others, they worship the absolute truth in three different ways. The first class, others. Amongst the others, there is first class, second class, third class. As amongst the direct worshippers, there are first class, second class, and third class. In every, department, as you have got experience in the material world, there are things, first class, second class, and third class. Even this whole material world is under first class, second class, and third class. The first class is mode of goodness, the second class is mode of passion, and the third class is mode of ignorance. Similarly, every department, more or less, there are three classes. So, amongst the persons who worship the Absolute Truth, not directly as the Personality of Godhead, but as Ahangruha Upasana. Ahangruha Upasana means taking himself as the Supreme. This we have already explained. The taking himself as the Supreme means, as a part and parcel of the Supreme, if we study myself, then I can understand also what is God. The only difference is, quantitatively, God is great and I am small. Otherwise, so far quality is concerned, there is one. So this Ahangruha Upasana, that is number one. Then next Upasana, next worship is Ekatvena Prithaktvena. Prithaktvena means pantheism. Just like there are persons who worship any demigod as God. Their opinion is that there are different forms of God. So any form we accept as God and worship, we shall be benefited, we shall approach the highest perfection. That is another section. So this can be adjusted that God is everywhere. There is no denying this fact. Because by His energy, He is everywhere. Just like we are His energy. Living entities, they are superior energy of God. Aparayam itastu vidhime prakritim para. Para means superior. So we are also energy. So energy and the energetic, they're one. Just like the sun and the sunshine. They are not different. So, wherever the sunshine is there is sun. You cannot deny that. Wherever the sunshine is there is sun. Similarly, wherever the energy of God is there is God. So in that way, everything is God, plethora of things. Everything, pantheism. These are different processes. But these processes one has to transcend. Just like simply studying the sun sign is not complete study of the sun. Although sun sign is not different from the sun, still, if you simply study scientifically what is the molecules, what are these rays, what is the billion illuminated things, so many things you can go on studying. That is also one sense studying sun, but not sun also. Kapritadattena and Vishutomukham. Vishutomukham means the universal form. Just like it is stated in the Shastra, the hills are their bones of God. The trees and grass and vegetation, they are just like hairs on the body of the God. So the ocean is the navel of God. In this way there are descriptions. The highest planet, Brahmaloka, that is the head of God. The lowest planet, Pataloka, that is, soul of the God. These things are described, the whole universal form. So somebody prefers the universal form, somebody prefers that everything, whatever you see, it is God, and somebody prefers that I am God. So these are different methods of appreciating God, but they are also accepted because they have taken into the line. They are better than who are just like animals, simply eating, sleeping, and defending and mating. But those who have taken either of these, Jnanajaddena, Prithakatena, and Vishutomukham, so those who are impersonalists, they prefer these three processes. And those who are personalists, they prefer directly to us the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. So they are all transcendentalists, they are on the line. But here in the Bhagavad Gita, those who are directly worshipping the Supreme Lord, they have been described as Mahatma. And those who are worshipping in other processes, they have been described Anne. Anne means others. So they have not been given so much importance, although they have been accepted. Because they have come to the line. Because suppose you are accepting the universal form of God, that is a fact also. Because the universe, the manifestation of the universe, is also manifestation of the energy of God. And the energy of God and God is not different. So therefore, one who takes the manifestation of the energy as God, he is not mistaken. That is also true. Because there is nothing beyond God. If you think I am God, yes, you are also God. Because there is nothing beyond God. Ahangro Pasana. If you think everything is God, that is also true. Because in the higher conception, there is nothing beyond God. Sarvam Khalidam Brahma. Sarva, everything. But the Vaishnav, those are personalists, they take it in a different way. Why? Because in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said by the law, Maya tatamidam sadmam jagat abhaktamurtina. I am spread all over the universe, all over the manifestation, in my impersonal feature. Masani sarvabhutani naham tesu avastita. Everything is resting on me, but I am not there. Pashamai yogamaitaram. So these simultaneously one and different, this philosophy is accepted by Lord Chaitanya. But It is also accepted in the Bhagavad Gita. The matta paratara nasti kinchidasti dhananjaya. But these four, these two hands with flute, Krishna, form of Krishna, there is nothing beyond this. So one has to come to this point. You may go in different ways, accepting yourself as God, accepting everything as God, accepting the universal form of God. If you make actually progress, then you have come to this point. Mahatma-sudhullam. Again, he says Mahatma. When he comes to that point of Krishna, Bahunam Janmanam, this process you have to proceed, you have to make progress, many, many births. That is lying, you have taken the lying, that's all life. But it will take some time. Not in one life you will come to that point. So therefore in the Bhagavad Gita it is said that Bahunam Janmanam Anti. This is culture or spiritual knowledge, that's all right. But simply by culture or spiritual knowledge, without favor, without mercy of the Supreme Lord, you cannot approach the ultimate goal. That's in the 18th chapter you'll find the Bhaktamama Vijana. These are all partial understanding of the Supreme Lord. But if you accept this process of Krishna consciousness, then you directly approach. Directly approach. Because after all, unless you approach to that point, then Vasudeva Sarvamiti. Here is Lord Sri Krishna Vasudeva. He is everything. So, those who are intelligent, they take the root. You see? Therefore, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, you find a very nice verse, Krishna de bhaje sevara chatur. Chatur means very intelligent. One who worships Krishna directly is very intelligent. Why he is very intelligent? He does not take so much roundabout way, he goes directly. If it is a fact that one has to come to this point for perfection of knowledge, why not take it immediately? I may not understand anything. I accept it. Let me accept it blindly. Some scientists and some laymen. And the teacher said, this is fire. Oh, scientists say, oh, I will see the characteristics of fire. I must see. Then I shall accept. All right, you can see. And somebody says, all right, you are teacher, you are saying, it is fire. All right, I accept it. But the scientists who after studying the characteristics of fire may come to the fire, he will also feel the warmth of the fire, the heat of the fire, the light of the fire, he will also understand. And this man blindly or by devotion, by love, accept, the result is the same. Because fire is fire. Either you blindly touch it, or you scientifically touch it. Far elect. So, this Bhagavad Gita says that those who are trying to make a show of their knowledge, so let them do that. Visvatomakam, the universal form, pantheism, monotheism, monism, there are so many theories there. But not a theory. So, these have come to this point. And some Mahatma Sudullava. Why does he say some Mahatma Sudullava? Because this path is not very easy. Spiritual path and to attain complete perfection is not very easy. Especially in this age. In this age, we are not living for a long time, we are not very intelligent. We may think that we are very intelligent, but we are not intelligent. Because we do not know what I am. Ask anybody what you are, he has the conception of this body. Therefore he is not intelligent. As soon as one will say, yes, I am this, such and such gentleman, a son of such and such gentleman, my country is such and such, these are all false. So, nobody knows it. Therefore, one who does not know it, Chaitanya Sanatana Goswami, we are teaching in the morning, he said, the Gramma Bavahare Kahe Pandi. In the layman, they call me a very learned man. I accept it. But actually I am not learned. Why? Because I do not know what I am. If I do not know what I am, then what is the use of other knowledge? So, actually, the intelligent person who knows his real position, his constitutional position, and his relationship with Krishna, then he gets directly this Krishna consciousness. And that is recommended in the Bhagavad Gita and all scripture. All scripture. But if you want to go roundabout way, you can go, but you have come to this ultimate point. That is the confusion. Then, there are divisions of Vedic knowledge. Fruitive activities, worship, and knowledge. Lord Sri Krishna is describing about the fruitive activities, sacrifice. In sacrifice we require so many things. Drabbajagga. By material things we require clarified butter, we require grains, we require mantra, chanting, and fire. So many things we require. Lord says, Aham krutu, aham jagya, sadaham, aham ausadam, mantroham, aham evajyam, aham agni, aham hutam. Now all this paraphernalia for sacrificing jagya, for performing a sacrifice, the fire, the butter, the clarified, the wood, and the mantra, and other paraphernalia, everything is myself, everything I am. And that's true. Because everything is produced by his energy. Anything, whatever you take, that's a transformation of energy. Parasa brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. Whatever you are seeing in the universal manifestation, they are simply manifestation of the different energy of the Supreme Lord. Just like in this room, this illumination is the energy of this light. Therefore we are seeing each one another. Similarly, as the fire is placed in one place, but it distributes its heat and light. Similarly, although the Lord is in the Supreme Abode, his energy is active. The same example, just like the sun planet is far, far away, but its energy, sunshine, is all over distributed, over the manifestation, material manifestation. So he is everything. Pitaham asya jagata, mata dhata pitamaha, vedam pavitram amkara rikshama jajurevata. Then he says, pitaham asya jagata. I am the father of this material world. How he becomes father? What is the definition of father? The father who gives the seed, he is father. And again he says, mata and mother also. What is the definition of mother? The mother receives the seed from the father and the child is born. Similarly, this material energy is the mother. See, we have got this body from mother. So, this matter, material covering is the mother. And I am spiritual spark, the seed, I am the part of Supreme. So the material energy is also the energy of the Father, and as I am spiritual spark, I am also a part of the Supreme. So He is my Father and Mom. Therefore, somebody worships the Supreme Lord as Mana, Goddess Kali, or that is materialism. Because in the present conception of our life, this body given by the mother is matter. Therefore, worship mother means worship the matter. That's all. There are so many worship of mother. You worship your country. That is the same material worship. This is called Shakti Upasana. Shakti. Shakti means you are worshipping the energy of the Lord, not the Lord directly. You are worshipping the energy. With all this nationalism or communism we have discovered, they are, even the scientists, a scientist also, they are worshipping the mother. He is finding out the complexities of the matter. So he is also worshipping mother. The materialism. This is called materialism. One who is worshipping the mother, material energy. He is called Shakta. There are five stages of evolution. Shakta, then Ganapatta, then Saura, then Saiva, then Vaishnava, in this way. There are five stages. So these impersonalists, they worship in five ways. Panchupasana. They are called Panchupasana. So one, when he comes to the Vishnu state, he comes to the real state. But impersonal Vishnu, all pervading Vishnu, but when he comes to the personal Vishnu, then that is perfection of worship. So any kind of worship the Lord accepts in this way. But that acceptance and devotional acceptance is different. If you are worshipping materialism, that's all right. You get material benefit. Actually, you are getting. You are getting. But that is not spiritual. Jeta thamang prapadante tang sasiyo bhajama. One who worships the Supreme Lord, material, he gets material benefit. And one who worships spiritual, he gets spiritual benefit. But you cannot expect spiritual benefit by material worship. That is not possible. Everything accepted as the worship of the Supreme. But they have got different result also. Just like in the ordinary life, you are working in office as a clerk, you cannot expect the salary of the High Court judge. How can you expect? As you are working, you get a salary. Similarly, everything is God, that's all right. Everything is government service. But a police constable is not equal to the magistrate. He can say, a constable can say that I am in government service, that's all right. But you are not equal to the magistrate. You are not equal to the High Court judge. You may be government servant, that's all right. So similarly, everything is worship of God, that's all right. But he cannot be equal to the supreme worshipper. Nachamang. There is nobody dearer than me, than he in the Bhagavad Gita, I'll find. So our ultimate aim is how to become in confidence of the Supreme Lord. So if you want to be in confidence of the Supreme Lord, then you have to take this devotional service. Bhaktya mam avijanati javana jasrami tattataha. The Lord says, one can confidentially understand me by bhakti, by devotional service, not by any other means. Not by any other means. Bhakta is clearly said. So if you want to be directly in touch with the President, then you have to work differently. And if you are satisfied to become a constable in the government service, and that is it. He cannot compare. So there, although everything is God worship, still there are degrees, there are differences. We must remember. Then he says, Gati Bhakta Prabhu Shakshi Divasa Saranam Suhit Prabhava Palayasthanam Nidhanam Bijam Abhayam. The Lord says, the Gati Bhakta. Gati means, everyone is coming to me gradually. Gati, that means destination. They're all coming to me. And Bhakta, Bhakta means maintainer. God is maintaining us. God is maintaining us and is giving us chance, all life, you come this way or that way, that's all life, come gradually, gradually, that's all life. Gati Bhakta, Prabhu, Prabhu means He is the Lord, nobody can be equal, otherwise there is no question of worship. If you think that I am God, so there is the process of worship also. I mean to say, Ahangrahopasana, just like we devotees, we offer flowers to the Lord, they take the flower and offer to themselves. So, we offer the garland to the Supreme Lord in the statue or the form of God, and they take the garland and put on his own neck. Is it? So, the question is that if you are God, then why you are worshiping? Why others not worshiping you? You are worshiping yourself. So what kind of God you are? Everyone worships. Oh, I am the Lord. I am everything. So this is a sense that in that process one may understand if one day comes into his tent. Well, I am God, I am worshipping myself, but if I go to the street, nobody asks me. What kind of God I am? So this sense should come. I may think, well, I understand that God lifted the hill, Krishna, he lifted the hill at the age of 7 years. No, I cannot lift even 100 pounds or 50 pounds. What kind of God I am? That this sense should come. You can worship yourself as God, that's all right, that's the process. That process is to understand that you study yourself and then you understand the real constitution of God, not that you become God. So these are different methods, of course, but we should not be satisfied simply by the methods. We should try to go further on and on. Just like a little boy, he is promised by the father. He is in the 8th class. Father says, my dear boy, if you can pass this 8th class, then I can make you a magistrate. I shall make you a magistrate. A boy is very into this. I shall become a magistrate. You see? So similarly, these are some of the encouragement. But the actual point is that you have come to the last point is Vasudeva Saraniti, Samahatma, Sudurlava. If you want to be the real great soul, then you have to come ultimate to Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Thank you.